The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... Come in. Welcome. I'm E.G. Marshall. Welcome to the world of terrifying imagination, to the fear you can hear. Tonight, I hope you have strong stomachs, for we're bound on a Caribbean cruise. Oh, we don't expect rough sailing on the way. So if you are easily seasick, have no fears. Save them all for your landing on the twin island of Mauritia and San Dorin, for it is the home of voodoo and the living dead, the soulless legions of men who are called zombies.
That's it, compadres. That's the coffin we seek. Scrape away the earth so we can get the lid open. Soon we can steal another corpse for the witch doctor. That's it. Now, break open the lid. And swing it back. Muy bueno. Shine the light. Oh, must have been strong as an ox. He'll make a fine zombie brother for El Generalissimo's elite guard. Está bien, señor Ongan. Here is another carcass for your living dead.
Our mystery drama, The Walking Corpse, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Ian Martin and stars Tony Roberts. It is sponsored in part by Anheuser-Busch Incorporated, Brewers of Budweiser, and by the Kellogg Company, makers of Kellogg's Special K cereal. I'll be back shortly with Act One. The body of a dead person, given the semblance of life, usually for some evil purpose. That is a zombie. The very name itself is calculated to make the flesh creep and the blood run chill. But on a plane headed for Miami, taking them to their honeymoon, nothing could be further from the thoughts of Steve Ramsey and his new wife, Pat.
Oh, I can't believe I have you to myself for these few hours, Steve, let alone a glorious 2 weeks.
I don't know what other associate professors go through, but my first 2.5 years teaching parapsychology have laid me out. I can't wait for those hot sands and warm water.
Mm. Can I serve you a drink, sir?
Oh, now that's what I call perfect timing. Why not?
One more, and I can fly solo to Miami without the plane. Well,
then I'll join you. I can't have you orbiting alone.
May I get by, please, stewardess?
I'm sorry, sir. Just let me move the cart.
Oh, thank you.
Chris! It is Christopher.
Shh. It's all right, stewardess. I'll join my friend here for a moment.
Hey, Steve, man. Good to see you.
Here. I'll move over. Sit down. Chris, you look something else. It's great to run into you. Only just for a moment, dear, I thought you were thinking of giving me the brush.
You? Never. I'll explain in a minute.
Oh, Pat, this is Christopher LeClaire. I want you to meet my brand new bride.
Oh, this is a pleasure, Mrs. Ramsey. Let me congratulate you on your impeccable taste, Steve, and both of you on your marriage. I'd like to buy some champagne, but you already have your drinks.
No more champagne, thank you. We've had enough in the last few weeks to float a battleship.
At least, let me get a drink for myself to toast the bride and groom.
He's your old football buddy, right?
Yeah. Greatest running back I ever saw. All-around athlete. He could have made it big in the pros. Any sport.
Isn't he a prince or something?
And his father is the king of Mauritia. I wonder what's bugging him.
Well, this is better. A toast from my country. To be a good man is first to have a good wife. Abus antes.
Thank you, Chris. And to yours.
Yours, too.
Oh, yes. Drink to my good health, please.
What is it, Chris? You want to talk about it?
I wish I still had you calling the place for me, but this is a different ballgame. You know about my father?
No. What?
He's dead.
Oh.
Oh, no. What can I say? Hang in there, man.
Oh, I will be tough, all right.
Was it recent?
The day before yesterday.
I didn't see anything about it in the papers.
It wasn't in the papers. He didn't die. He was assassinated.
Oh, no.
Any idea who did it?
There is no proof, but I know.
Who?
Maybe not by his own hand, but at least on his orders. Hernando Trujillo.
The Generalissimo? But I thought he was your father's best friend.
And my godfather. His gift to me on my 21st birthday. His own good luck charm. The bracelet of the sacred serpent. The head, the voodoo symbol of life. The tail, the symbol of death. You see, they are woven together.
But then why should he?
Because, Mrs. Ramsey, my father gave our people freedom. A freedom the Sand or Indian cannot share.
Why not?
Because if they had it, they would tear the man who rules them by terror to pieces.
So he's planning to move in on Moesha and annex it?
The moment my father's assassination is revealed. A coup d'etat while the people are in confusion with no leadership. That's why I've given up any dream of becoming a doctor. And I'm going home. A private plane will meet me in Miami to fly me to Moesha. To save time, I took this commercial flight under an assumed name.
You think Trujillo might...
I was warned just in time. Less than an hour after I left my apartment, a bomb gutted it. I'm a dangerous man to know these days. So, before I do cause any... Oh, my God!
Steve, what is it?
Two hoods with machine guns. Looks like a sky.
Senores and senores, ladies and gentlemen.
Oh, my God.
May I have your attention, please?
That's Juan Garcia, Trujillo's hatchet man.
What can we do?
Nothing. It's me.
Everyone quiet. If you do as I say, no one will be hurt. We are commandeering this flight. Quiet! Quiet! There is nothing for any of you to fear. The plane will land at Miami, and all passengers will be discharged, except for the flight crew and four hostages. I repeat, there is no cause for alarm if all of you keep your seats and your heads.
Still, everybody, just follow orders. Anyone who doesn't will be shot. Okay. All right. You three, up and into first class.
Look, Garcia.
No names. No wrong moves. My orders are to bring you dead or alive.
I was only going to ask that my friends...
Your friends can identify you. We don't want that for a few days. They will only be held as hostage till we are ready. If they do as they are told, they will be released unharmed. Now move. Join the other hostages you were sitting with in first class.
Steve, I'm so sorry.
It's not your fault. You okay, Patricia?
Ready, unwilling, but able.
That's my gal. Let's go.
Just walk ahead of me, nice and steady. Muy bien, mis amigos. Sanka! Roban! Nobody moves till I come back. Okay? Inside. That's it. Go sit by him. Quito, don't let them move till I come back.
I'm sorry I got you into this.
Yeah, we'll make out. Are you okay, honey?
Well, a few butterflies in the stomach. What does he want?
To move in and sit down, I think.
Better keep him happy. He's a surly character at best. Why don't we sit in these four together? Our friend's a little deaf.
If we keep far enough away, we can talk safely, if we keep our voices down.
Why are you being held hostage?
Any number of reasons. I'm U.S. government. I know who you are. They took a dim view of me for carrying a gun, and they have a pretty good idea of who I am, too.
Well, who are you?
Hawkins will do. Bill Hawkins.
What branch of the government?
Well, I think I won't reveal that. I was assigned to see that you cleared the country safely, Your Highness. Someone slipped me a knockout drop in the coffee. That's when I lost consciousness and my gun.
You were asleep when I came back. Oh, this is Mr. and Mrs. Steve Ramsey.
And you, Steve, ma'am.
Yeah, hi, Hawkins.
How do you do, Mr. Hawkins?
Any idea what their plans are?
Refuel, clear the rest of the passengers out. Then?
Then we head straight for San Dorinde.
That's the notion. So, the moment they get our friend Christophe here to San Dorinde, he's a gone goose. He'll just drop out of sight suddenly and for good. Now, my guess is they'll set up one of these goons as a fall guy, have a big show trial, and in the meanwhile, return the plane with us aboard. Only, somewhere on the way, we'll all disappear in a puff of plastic bomb smoke. We're just as long gone as the king here.
What's the alternative?
Distract Ugly there long enough for one of us to disarm him. Garcia and his other boys can only get at us through the narrow passageway between tourist class and here. I can keep them pinned down till you get out the emergency exit.
He's a big guy, but I'll admit...
Okay, no time to argue. Now, how do we distract him?
That's my job.
Pat, please, stay out of this.
I'm in it just as much as all of you. Watch this. Hey, mister, come here a second. Okay, then, I'll come to you. Take it easy. I just want to ask something. If you can't hear me, I can't speak any louder. Oh, please, come closer. That's it. I just want to ask whether
Ow.
Ladies...
Watch it, he's strong as a bull.
Ah. God, he's broken my arm.
It's all right. I have the gun. Stay where you are.
Don't let him near you.
I'll shoot.
What are you waiting for?
All right, Guido, pick up your gun.
Chris! You shot him, Garcia. You killed him.
I talk him dead or alive. It makes no difference.
But that other man, Chris shot him twice.
Point blank, it should have killed him.
Guido? Oh, no. Don't you know you can kill a zombie?
Coming in for the landing now. How's Chris?
He's alive, but just barely.
If he can just hang on, maybe when we land, a doctor can help
him. Too late for me.
Don't give up, Chris.
Take snake.
What?
The snake bracelet. He wants you to... Here. There. Steve has it, Chris.
Good. Listen. You go dans ce loge. She hide you. Save you. Give her bracelet.
But where do we find her? Où est votre tante? Quelle rue? Quelle place?
Pense-moi. Avenida. De las... Muñecas.
Avenue of the Dolls. Yes, what number?
Oh, Ben. Oh, Gray Serpent. Take me home. Take me home. Dans ce loge. Help. This sign of the black. Pull.
We're about to land. Pretty short runway. Better fasten your seatbelts.
I'll get yours for you.
Not the most promising way to begin a honeymoon, particularly when it seems there is more than a little chance of ending it, even before it's begun. Who knows what kind of reception is ahead for the newlyweds? I'll be back shortly with Act Two. Under other circumstances, Pat and Steve would have no complaints about their accommodations on the island. Drained and exhausted, the silk-sheeted bed in an expensive suite is an alluring invitation to sleep. Except, even if you are dead to the world, who wants to become part of the world of the dead?
Oh, Steve. Is it possible? Could there really be such a thing as a zombie?
No, of course not. It's just a superstition.
But you saw Chris fire two bullets right into his body.
Yes.
And he didn't even flinch.
Cogito ergo sum.
What?
I think, therefore I am. Pat, look, under any other circumstances, I'd be fascinated. I mean, this is my field.
And you do believe that there are walking dead?
Do I believe that a man can be exhumed from the grave and life breathed back into his corpse? No. No, I can't accept that. That's beyond my credulity. But I've seen things in parapsychological experiments and in psychic research that... Honey, the power of supernatural belief is beyond belief. The right subject, particularly one of low mentality, under hypnosis, is capable of incredible feats. Superhuman strength, no sensation of pain, no shock reaction. Oh, Lord. Now what?
The knock wasn't at the door we came in. It's that one over there.
Oh, wait a minute. Stay where you are, Pat. Yes? Who is it?
Bill Hawkins. I'm in an adjoining room. Is there a boat on your side?
Yeah. Half a sec. Hiya, Bill. Listen, we've got to talk.
What's the sense in talking? Hello, Pat.
Hello, Bill. How's your arm?
Feels fine. They did a real good job of patching it up. I just wondered before we all turned in if you had a radio in here.
There's one right over there.
Good. Mind if I turn it on and see if I can catch some news? Uh-oh. Only one band. Well, let's see what it's got. Hey, I see they provided you with a meal, too.
I never even noticed.
Pretty good grub. You should try it.
I wouldn't touch it.
Nor I. Look, I don't see how well.
All right, we can cut the comedy now. This place is bugged. The radio ought to block us out. Now, we've got to plan some kind of escape.
How?
I may have that lined up. It's where to hole out after we bust from here that's got me stumped.
I've got a possible answer to that.
What?
Saint Solange.
Who? Chris's aunt. She lives here.
Where?
The Avenue of the Dolls.
It's a long, winding street. Any idea where?
You know it?
Well, I spent 6 months on Secret Service here before we closed down our embassy. Did he give you a cross street, a number?
He was pretty incoherent before he died. When I asked him, he just sort of rambled on about the great serpent and the black bull or something.
The serpent is the basic symbol of the voodoo religion. Black bull I never heard of in this liturgy. Wait a minute. The chicken in the Obia cult is a sacrificial animal considered to... Maybe it was the black pull. He was trying to say black pullet. Does that mean anything to you, Bill?
Yeah. Wait a minute. It's a sort of a souvenir shop. You know, a typical tourist trap with straw hats and dolls and voodoo drums, you name it.
Yeah, well, could you find it?
Sure, it's not far from here.
But how do we get out first?
You got slacks on. Good. You got a dark scarf to cover that blonde hair?
Right here.
All right, come with me. Walk soft. Keep your voices low. Turn up that radio a little.
Roger.
Leave it open. Come over here to my window. Now keep off to the sides. Now look down.
There's one of those zombies down there.
But you see, there's a balcony and steps that lead to the street.
Oh, with a something subhuman, or maybe I should say superhuman, armed with a gun right at the bottom of them.
If he's cold-cocked, it isn't going to do him any good.
Bill, you have a lot of guts, but you're no Muhammad Ali, and the only strength I have is in my brain.
Hold out your hands. I'm going to give you the equalizers. Steve, with his fist wrapped around a roll of nickels or quarters, a 13-year-old boy could deck Joe Frazier, given the chance to blindside him.
Yeah, but we haven't got...
Keep your hands out. Now, this is a salt cellar. Same difference. I'm spilling the salt into your left hand. Wrap the other around this heavy crystal. I'm doing the same with the pepper. Now, you, Pat...
Oh, I wouldn't know
how. You're going to cover us by making a diversion. Pick up that glass water pitcher there. Too heavy for you to throw?
No. Throw where?
We turn off the lights, turn off the radio, make like we're turning in. Then we sneak out the French windows onto the balcony. You go off to the right, opposite end from the steps. When that zombie reacts to the crash of that pitcher on the flagstones on your side, Steve and I go down the steps and take him out. Then we go look for Toss Solange.
Now? But he'd see you.
Of course. So we wait until dark. And that won't be long now. Now! You take him, Steve!
He's still not out.
I'm throwing the pepper. Throw the salt in his eyes.
There you are.
Watch it!
I think I killed him.
Well, don't stop to find out. The light's going on. Come on, Pat. We'll have to run for it. Hold it. We'll have to chance the light.
Which way?
Ahead. To the right. Go to the next block. They're right on our heels. Give me that flashlight and you get out of here, both of you.
What about you?
Don't be a fool. Somebody's got to be a decoy. You have a wife to think of. Now hurry.
Come on, Pat. Run.
To the left! They went to the left! Follow that light!
Yes?
Tante Solange.
Who wants her?
I am Christopher's friend with my wife. We are running from Tujedo, the Generalissimo. Christopher told me to seek refuge here and to bring you this.
The great serpent. A moment. Enter, my children. Quickly, quickly. So, turn out your lights also. We must hide like cats in the dark. So, they have killed little Christophe. First my brother, then his son. Well, he will be made to pay. An eye for an eye, a heart for a bleeding heart. Now shall the tyrant bleed. Now at last my curse shall enter his vitals. Now will the great serpent uncoil and strike Hernando Trujillo dead.
Oh, it wasn't the Generalissimo who shot Chris.
It was a man named Garcia.
Garcia! That jackal puppet dangled by the strings. That less than nothing with no mind or will of his own.
Is he a zombie too?
What do you know of zombies, my child?
Nothing. Except what I saw on the plane and what my husband tried to tell me.
Oh, you are a teacher in college, Monsieur Ramsey, no?
Yes, and much of my studies are in the supernatural.
You believe in zombie?
Well, no, not altogether.
Very well. We shall put our beliefs to the test.
It's a doll, like the ones you sell in the store here.
Not quite the same. This one is like the souvenirs of El Generalissimo. With this difference. I have been a long time making him. You see, the straw is from his favorite horse's stall. The beard is made from the combings of his hairbrush. The eyes, J-chips from a dress coat button. The boots from the fingers of an old glove. This is a voodoo doll. All of him is made with things that once belonged to Trujillo. Only one last thing I needed to make the spell work. The weapon. Now, at last, I have in my hand the instrument of destruction. I straighten out the circle, turn the head to the sky, and death. The tail towards the ground and strike! have I done, Mr. Ramsey?
You drove the bracelet like a knife straight through the doll's head.
From temple to temple. Hernando Trejo will be dead by midnight. And we will all be free. You still do not believe. Let us find how strong your science holds against my faith.
What's that?
Trejo's men. The doll. They must not find the doll. Help me pin it under my skirt.
Oh, my hands are shaking so much.
Bon. Just in time.
So, we meet again, Señor Ramsey.
How did you find us?
Your friend Hawkins.
He gave us away?
Señor Ramsey, every man will give anything away with the right persuasion. Señor Hawkins took longer than most. He was very foolish.
What do you mean?
Since in the end he told, why was it worth dying for? Vamos, you must not keep the Canarisimo waiting.
Please, let me assure you that you have nothing to worry about. I ask you all to relax. Now, the tavern is set for a late supper. I am sure you must all be famished after a long and difficult day. Won't you be my guests?
Prisoners, you mean?
Trujillo.
Ah, yes. La bonne princesse Solange, I am honored. I had no idea you had come to live among us.
I have been here longer than you know.
Yes, I must speak to my secret police about that. Had I been told you were honoring our country with a visit, I would have arranged a more suitable welcome.
I am sure you would. By disposing of me as you did my brother and my nephew, Christophe.
I suppose it would be impossible for me to convince you that I had no hand in the death of King Francois. The sad truth is that his heart failed him. His death was a natural one.
Lie upon lie. But one truth you cannot twist. The death of my nephew.
Did you see him die?
There are two witnesses before your desk who did.
Ah. Excuse me a moment. Garcia, are you ready? Si, now. We must wait for a moment.
For what?
You will see. Senora Ramsey, let me ask you a question.
What?
Did you see Christophe Leclerc die?
Yes.
And you, senor?
Yes.
You are quite sure?
Of course.
Yes. Look, what are you trying to prove?
Not I. I will let him show you that for himself. You see?
Chris!
Mon cher baby!
Steve! He's alive! It's Chris!
Chris? Is it really you?
Sure, man. Sure. Don't you know me?
There is no mistaking the tall, lithe figure, the regal bearing, the proud, handsome face. All those belong to Christophe Leclerc. He might easily have remarked, as Mark Twain once telegraphed, "The reports of my death are an exaggeration." We'll return shortly with Act Three. At the shock of the reincarnation of a dead man appearing from the grave, it is not surprising that his friends and relative are literally frozen in their tracks. Under the circumstances, then, it is only decent courtesy for the returned corpse to break the ice.
Tante Solange, qu'est-ce que c'est? Have you no greeting for me?
Ah, mon pauvre, je te remercie, pardon. Forgive me. I thought never to see you again.
But here I am.
Ah, mon cher baby, mon cher baby.
Well, now, here is a reunion worth celebrating.
That was a pretty rough wound you had, Chris.
Worse than it looked. Thank God, it was mostly flesh damage. The doctors tell me the bullet bounced off my sternum and never entered the chest.
But should you be on your feet?
Long enough to ease your minds about me. I'm still a bit woozy.
It was like the time you took the XB2 slant off tackle against Ohio State and that big linebacker, Sawchuck, kicked you in the head.
Something like that. Tell them the good news, El Generalissimo. Set my aunt's mind at rest.
Well, I know you hold out my motives, even Christoph did. I can hardly blame him, since I took such extreme measures to bring him here to Sandorinde before his planned arrival at the Boeotia.
What was your reason for that?
We walk a tightrope on this shared island of ours. Two cultures, two languages, two forms of government perched precariously on an ever-increasing population in a far more ancient and primitive culture than either of ours. Your brother and I, each in his own way, preserve that delicate balance. With his unexpected death, steps had to be taken.
Why? You know his plan was to return the government to the people.
That would not have worked, not even for them. We would have ended, both of us, in anarchy. Fortunately, my godson was perceptive enough to realize that. We have worked out between us a better plan.
A compromise?
I would prefer to call it an entente. But tell them, Christoph.
It's quite simple. Tomorrow, together, my godfather and I shall proclaim a union between Mauritia and Sandorinde. A trilingual state with one government.
Ruled by whom?
By the Generalissimo and myself. I as president, and my godfather as prime minister.
Trujillo in second place?
We elders grow no younger, Solange. Someone must take our place. We have worked happy to yield to the future. What better hands could this island be in than in Christoph's? So, now I think, Mr. Presidente, you should rest. Doctor
and I shall
only so much. Nature handles the rest.
Yes. I would like to lie down.
I am sure you will be excused. I beg you not to wait for me to enjoy your supper. The Presidente and myself have a few matters to settle about the announcement tomorrow before he goes to sleep.
Forgive me, please. I'm tired. And tomorrow's a big day. Good night.
Good night, Chris.
Good night.
Adieu, mon baby. Goodbye. Forever.
What is it? What's the matter with you two?
You saw? You know? Do you now believe in zombies?
What are you trying to say?
That wasn't Chris who was here just now.
I don't understand.
You don't know him as I do. First, he never would accept this deal. The guy is too decent, too honest to be part of it. But there are other things.
What?
Well, first off, our school never played Ohio State. Second, Sawchuck was no linebacker, but a running back who murdered us on the only loss we had together. Third, XB2 wasn't a run play, but a deep pass play that had nothing to do with Chris except as a decoy.
I don't understand the things your husband says, but I tell you, that was not Christophe Leclerc who just left. Not my nephew. They have stolen his soul. And that I cannot allow.
Well, what can we do about it, Tante Solange?
It is a very few minutes to 12. I told you Hernando Trujillo would be dead by then. Remember?
Yes.
Here is a conjured doll which will make his death. I place it on his desk.
B2,
what can see it? For it is by his own guilt he must die before the end of this day.
But if he doesn't return?
He will return It is written in the dust.
Oh, nobody feels like eating. Words, I don't suppose I can altogether blame you. Shall I have you shown to your quarters for the night instead?
Where is Christoph?
Oh, I should never really have allowed him to overtax himself after being wounded. He was absolutely exhausted. I saw him to bed.
And you return to suggest the same to us?
I think we are all tired. Whatever discussion there may be between us can wait for tomorrow.
For you, there is no tomorrow.
What do you mean?
Liar, cheat, thief, murderer. Look on your desk.
A conjured doll.
Your image. Made piece by piece from your belongings. Fashioned in your likeness. Christened in your name with the blood of the Black Bullet. Your own bracelet of the sacred serpent driven through its brain.
Do you think I could buy such childish superstition? I am no savage.
What a man thinks is what he is.
This primitive mumbo-jumbo will have no effect on me.
Are you murder? How large is the bag of guilt you carry?
Will nothing convince you, woman? Your nephew and
my nephew!
Christoph!
Christoph is dead!
How can you say that? You have just seen him!
I saw a walking corpse!
More idiot superstition!
Like my conjured doll?
Of course!
You don't believe in it.
No!
And you believe in zombies. You know the power of voodoo can create them. You know the power of voodoo can kill.
What is it you want?
Too late for that.
I will give you anything. I offer you and these two safe transport now. No strings attached.
How can you guarantee it?
I am head generalissimo. My power is infinite.
Not anymore. The clock is ticking your life away.
No.
12 o'clock. Only a few seconds left.
Help me. Help me.
I cannot help. The die is cast. No. You cannot even help yourself.
I will give you money, jewels, anything. Name it. What do you want?
What you cannot give me. What you stole from my nephew. His soul. I want yours in return.
I know.
Then die. By the power granted me as an Obia woman, vested in my hands by the uncoiling sacred serpent to take the place of the voodoo doll, as it should to all tyrants, so comes a violent death to you. I condemn you to everlasting fire and death by the serpent writhing in your
No, brain. No! I cannot die! I am the dictator! I am supreme! I am the law! No one can touch me, do you hear? No one! You condemn me! Why, all I have to do is raise this pistol and you...
I wouldn't like to guess.
Does it matter? He's dead.
Are you sure?
Well, he's dead, all right. Now what?
Gotta get away. Escape somehow.
Yeah, only how do we get through the palace guard? At least I have his gun. We better try and make a run for it.
We have to rescue my nephew first.
But Countess Solange, he's our enemy now.
I still must rescue him.
Mi perdona, generalissimo.
Watch him, see me on the gun!
That's for Bill Hawkins. Pat, tell him to run for it. I'll try to hold him off.
You can't kill dead men with that. Garcia, yes, but not a zombie. Hand me that salt cellar.
Here, but what good...
Salt is the only thing that will kill a zombie.
It's Chris. Lying on the bed. Is he...
No. No, he's still breathing. He's just asleep.
Leave me alone with him. Go.
Bellissimo.
But leave me with Christoph.
Will you be long?
As long as it must take. Go.
Well, we can't find our way out of here without you. We'll wait.
Oh, great serpent who coils about the sky and holds our world together. Help me now. Help me to break the black magic that chains my baby to a living death. Help me to bring his soul home to you. Christoph. Christoph. Listen to me. It is Tanta Solange who speaks. You know me as an Obia magician. My magic is greater than the magic of the Hugan who made you what you are. He summoned you from the grave and stole away your soul. Now I must summon you back to the grave. Back to the dead. The everlasting dead. So that your immortal soul may live. But only you can break the bonds. Rise, zombie. Rise. And cross to the window. Open the shutters. Now, open your eyes and look at the sea.
No! No!
In the name of the great serpent, I command you, open your eyes.
Dante! Dante! I'm going. My baby.
Tanta, are you all right?
What happened? Is he?
His body may be dead, but his soul is safe. Christoph is home. At last.
The death of the dictator set a people free in a mad orgy of festival and delight. In the wild celebration that lit up the city, no one had time to pay any attention to the three somber people who found their way back to the hotel. For Pat, Steve, and Tanta Solange, there was sadness. But solace, too. The king was dead, but so was the zombie who might have held him prisoner for eternity. I'll return shortly. Power of suggestion, hypnosis, superstitious fear, overpowering guilt complexes, terror of the unknown. Do any or all of these explain the events of the tale I've just told? Or are there really such terrifying things as a walking corpse? Are there really zombies? Well, let's hope you and I never have to find out. Our cast included Tony Roberts, Suzanne Grossman, Vinette Carroll, Bob Caliban, Jackson Beck, and Ian Martin. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.